Hello, hello, everybody. It's 7:22 a.m. Central Time on the 16th of November, 2022. Hope you're doing well. We're here at an early morning update. And man, I've got something to show you guys. First of all, we just need to get up here on the screen. An earthquake has struck here in Belgium, of all places. A rare earthquake. Now, I have a warning going at the English Channel right next to it, and up in Scotland, earthquake warning. And so this spot here, again, it's just amazing what we're looking at here, guys. This earthquake has struck at a spot that I have to show you. So I'm going to get a display capture turned on. We're going to go pull the coordinates from the Europeans on this, put them in on Google Earth. And now, again, I'm going to back this out just so you can see we're here in Europe, and put the coordinates in, paste, and search. I am recording this, and I am certainly going to have to put this out over on YouTube in light of where it's at, what we just found out. So you can clearly see we're right at the border of Netherlands and Belgium. Zooming in on the coordinates provided by the Europeans, and we're going to get this location here. And, well, let me just back this out and show you what it's called. The Belgian Nuclear Research Centre. So we have an earthquake down below, and the depth on this earthquake is 5 kilometers deep. So what's going on here is we've seen earthquakes strike. Let me give you an example. Japan, the megaquake back in 2011 with the big earthquake next to the Fukushima nuclear reactor. The Dodoward nuclear reactor that was decommissioned but still had the casket of material in Netherlands was hit with a 4.0 earthquake down below it. Over on the east coast of the United States, a 5.9 earthquake struck Mineral, Virginia, right next to the nuclear power plant in Virginia, as an example. Also in Illinois, the Byron nuclear power plant had a 2.0 earthquake next to it. I went up to go investigate it with a tritium leak as well accompanying that. I took readings outside of the nuclear power plant just to see if there was anything showing up, but the earthquake that accompanied it. So how does this happen? Well, it has to do with what's called electron cascade. Now, this is going to get real science sounding, but let me just put it like scuffing your feet across the carpet. And we all know that if it's on a dry day, you can pick up some free electrons off the carpeting and goes up into your body, and you store it like a battery or a capacitor. You go touch something and of course, the electricity comes out of your finger, it discharges down into ground again, okay? Well, in this case, radio waves and electricity itself can scuff its feet across the carpet of the atmosphere and as well as down in the earth. And same process builds, which is called electron cascade, the building up of electrons into something. In this case, radio waves, or in this case, very low frequency power. Very low frequency power. Power is working on very low frequency, and it is AC and DC. Now, AC is radio waves. If you don't know about AC, AC converts to DC, of course, in a rectifier, and you can rectify AC to DC. You can change a radio wave into power. For instance, NASA's already done that in big experiments using radar and beaming it a couple miles across valleys and converting it back, the microwave energy, converting it back into power, into DC, which they use to power light bulbs and so forth at a distance. And that was in the 1970s. I got those experiments on my channel and the radar tests from NASA and so forth. Well, here we are down below the nuclear power plant here in Europe with a 2.0 earthquake, 5 kilometers. Electron cascade. Now, the really way you should think about this is maybe they dumped a lot of electricity down into the ground for some reason. Maybe a switch hit, dumped how many megavolts or so forth of energy down into the crust. And then you get what you have is just a regular electrical discharge into the crust, a reverse lightning strike, basically. Lightning coming up out of the crust, right? Coming up from the core of the earth, out of the magma, going up into the sky, discharging with the differential up into space. All this would be going to ground in the opposite way, and it could lead to a discharge of power into the crust. Of course, we get earthquake activity accompanying that. So this is a prime example of electrical-induced earthquake activity. And I've been documenting this in the United States. It happens next to our solar power plants, our nuclear power plants. Our coal-fired power plants is another example of the rare earthquake striking off the coast out here in the Great Lakes. And right next to it here on the south side, we've got our coal-fired power plant that it was happening next to. Again, the electrical discharge the electron cascade into the ground. This was disputed, actually, by a lot of people for a long time. They said it was impossible. Even up until this year, they said it was impossible. I had professionals come over and say that there are no relations between earthquakes and electrical discharge. Well, here's one right below a nuclear power plant. So there is a relation. We know there's a relation. I'm keeping track of it and tracking where it's striking. In the United States, we get, I'd say, several hundred earthquakes per year that strike next to, down below, and along our power lines, not just the power stations. So it follows the power lines like a circuit board almost, because this flow, the seismic flow that I'm talking about that goes across Europe, for instance, why I'm looking for the English Channel to get hit, why I'm looking for Scotland to get hit, the seismic flow is very low frequency or greater, extremely low frequency, ultra low frequency, but it's a wave that's traveling through the plates. And as the wave travels through the plates, it's electrical in nature. It's traveling through the plate. It's a piezoelectric effect. If you go look it up, that's a science term if you want to. How do you say it? Piezoelectric or piezoelectric? Piezoelectric. I can't say it proper. It doesn't matter how you say it. Go look it up. It's electricity in the plate. Very low frequency induced. From Mother Nature, of course. Okay, so let's recap. Down below Belgium, I'm going to put the coordinates in again, and we're going to search. These are from the Europeans. 5 kilometers down below the Nuclear Research Center, the power generation on this facility here, going to the Nuclear Research Center. Hey, look, they just blinked. Look. Hey, look, they just, was it like that just a minute ago? I don't think it was like that just a minute ago. I don't know. I'm pretty sure it wasn't like that just a minute ago. But, okay, well, now it's grained out. Maybe I just was tripping and didn't realize that it was grained out like this. But it's a huge nuclear research facility, and right next to it, we've got the big-time power generation, or the big-time power transfer in. So the real question is there a reactor here? Or is there other kind of research being done here? Or do they just have some kind of major problem take place here? Now, again, I would wonder. Again, I don't see big reactors here. I see houses nearby. I see the nuclear research facility. This right here looks like some kind of actual warehouse. I'm talking about this facility here is what I'm talking about, with the power going to it. So I really, really got to figure out what the deal is with this location. Let's find out what it is. So, let's go to their website. Okay. Of course, this is where I need to speak a different language, right? Is this in Dutch? Or looks like it's in Dutch. Well, wow, didn't Artemis, huh? I'm going to have to say, I need to find, why would they have this blurred out if it was like some kind of college? What is this? Is that the reactor? Let's see if we can get a ground level on this damn thing. Since it's blurred out, you got to be kidding me, man. What is this? That looks like some kind of experimental reactor. With a lot of barbed wire and other things around it. That's what it looks like to me. Let's go down the road a little bit. See if we can see through the trees a little bit more. Since we have to peek through the trees to see it. What, am I living? Is this Russia?
Zranzvuci is a special agent Dutch since I am reporting for duty to the look at the nuclear reactor.
Look, the Google car shouldn't have driven down there. Look, they let him in.
Yeah, it's a nuclear reactor. Look at this.
Look at this. Yeah, there she blows. Not literally.
I hope not. But it's definitely a nuclear reactor. Glad I went down to ground level and checked.
You can do all the graining out you want. You can see through the trees. Wow. You're free over there, are you? I don't know. I don't think we're free anywhere anymore. So do you have an earthquake plan? This is why I need to do my research publicly. First of all, it gets captured publicly, live before an audience. People in Twitch watching now. This is also why I shouldn't be stopped from doing the research publicly in front of an audience and have people trying to stop me. For those people who said earthquakes were not happening below electrical stations and nuclear power plants, you were wrong. You need to acknowledge that and look into it. You could probably get a doctoral thesis written on this thing and make a real big name for yourself. And you probably don't even have to mention my name. Although, morally, you probably should. You don't have to. The point is that there's earthquake activity happening below nuclear plants, power lines, and it's following them like a circuit board would guide power across a circuit board. So, like, you would have circuits on a board and it would go across the board. Well, the board is made up of nothing more than layers, just like the plate is. So your green circuit board that has the circuits printed on it has electricity flowing through it, and all the components stick their prongs down through the board in order to draw power. And you connect it, components with the wires. Amazing. Anyway, you go to ground on that, by the way. When you go into the board, guess where that goes? So treat the board in your computer as if it's the crust of the earth. Now you all understand when there's a buildup of power onto it, that there's going to be something that happens down inside of it. A short, if you will, but in this case, it's a break. It's an earthquake that happens kilometers down below. It's amazing. I'm so glad I stayed up to document this. I've been up for almost 24 hours, so please forgive me if I sound like I'm a little tired, but catching something like this has to be put out over on YouTube, and I'm going to label it as Europe Nuclear Power Plant Earthquake. That's what I'm going to label it as. Maybe Belgium, but definitely everybody needs to see this. If you work in the industry, the electrical industry, this might not be a shock to you, right? A very low frequency can induce earthquake activity on the right frequency with the right amount of power dropped into the ground. Same principle applies to CERN. That's one to chew on. But CERN goes down to the core of the earth instead of just down at the plate down below. And it comes back up on the other side, on the antipode, with new deep earthquakes, with CERN, and the power it drops to the core of the earth instead of just into the plate. So, yeah, orders of magnitude less than CERN on the power coming from the nuclear power plant. Still, much love, everybody. Document everything that you find. Do not get bullied into not looking into things. And the more you get shut down, the more you come back. Can I get amen to that? Look what would have happened if I would have stopped. Things like this wouldn't be discovered. Peace out. Oh, and by the way, this is a big discovery. Right here. This one right here. Earthquakes below nuclear power plants proved. Maybe that's what I should put as the title of the video. But that's a big deal. Because everybody said it was impossible. Not only did they say it was impossible, they actually tried to shut me down for researching it. So, here we go. Let's go serve it back up to them. Nice swift upper punch over on YouTube. With a premiere. Peace out.